Whiskey Jason here, whiskey from the viewpoint of an American over here in Germany tasting rare and exotic whiskeys. Now I have from Signature Vintage the small batch edition number two. Number one will be in a moment. Single malt Scotch whiskey distilled at Glenrothes. I've never seen Glenrothes not spelled together, have you? And it is a vintage whiskey from 2011. Oloroso sherry and bourbon casks from Pitlochry to the world, aged 12 years. Interesting enough, it says unchilled filtered and no color added. Unchilled filtered, a new way to express yourselves. All right, so this is whiskey base number 237381. In Germany, it had a recommended retail price of $64.90. Immediately, it went to $59.90, the way things are today. Did you see the newest release here of Diageo special releases for 2023? There was like, here we have the recommended retail price and then the pre-sale price. It's like you can't even order it yet, and they're already reducing the price. I don't know. I don't get it. All right. So on the whiskey base site, it says here first fill Oloroso casks and ex bourbon casks. So here it doesn't say it. Now this is what like Signature Vintage often does. This is the whiskey lover's bottle. No label on the back. You can see the whiskey. It has a very sleek design with a cheap bottle, which we want. It has one label on it with all the information. You have vintage, you have age, you have ABV, you have casks. What more do you want? All right, so I'm sure there's a imprint someplace here where I can see when it was bottled, a timestamp. I can't find it. It's there someplace, I'm sure, but even there's a batch number there, and that's all. That's all you need, basically. There's no marketing blah blah, there's no fluff, there's no just terrible stories on here. This is a whiskey to be bought, to be drunk, to be enjoyed. As I said, $59.90. What am I going to compare it to? I'm going to compare it to Buna 12. Now, first of all, it's interesting that the colors have some sort of similarity. I don't know if that this looks older, this looks newer, but that's the first thing that I noticed was, hey, wait a second, colors are very close here. Now, Buna 12 is what? Sherry and bourbon. It's 46.3%, so it's actually not that far off. It's 12 years of age, 12 years of age, and over here in Germany, I can get this here for under 50 euros. So at least 10 euros less at the moment. So let's pour a little bit here and get this in the glass. Excellent. All right, there is the small batch series number one, which I'll be doing a video about next. I'll compare these two, but I wanted to compare these two, so I'm doing it in that order there. Let's smell, let's taste, let's enjoy. Just want to make sure my price for the Buna 12 is about right at the moment. Buna 12. Yeah, 44, 45 euros. All right, good. So that's what I was looking for here. What does the Buna 12 cost in Germany at the moment? I can get on Amazon at the moment for $44.99. So this is Buna. I enjoy. I'm really looking forward to the Buna 12 Castering 2023. It was just released yesterday, the day before. £99 should be about 99 euros here in Germany. They started off at 70, went up to 80, now they're over 90s. I still think it's a good price for what you're getting. I hope the 2023 is even better than the 2022. I thought the 2022 was better than 2021. So I'll buy a bottle, try it, and then I'll buy some more bottles if it's even close. So, all right, this is fall. This is foliage. This is leaves on the ground in autumn. This is very nice. There's a little bit of sulfur in there. There's a lot of cherry going on there. Now, there's sometimes I remember about a year or a year and a half ago, I was so sick and tired of all these syrup cherry things. This is a different type of sherry. This I like. This is sweet. This is cherry. This is fruity. This is nice. Do I like the Buna more? Maybe, maybe. I get a little bit of a sea breeze going on here and a little bit more of a leather moment going on here. So, very, very well done. This is at Masters of Malt in the UK. This is Whiskey Exchange. 18 different shops have it already in Germany. This is something that people are probably going to buy. There used to be the Seasons release from Kirsch Import here for Germany exclusive. They no longer have those. Instead, they have the small batch editions here. There were small batch editions cask strength. There are some small batch editions now in 48.3. Yep. 2, sorry, 48.2%. So let's try it. Sláinte. My tongue tingles, and not from alcohol. The alcohol is there. There's a little bit of bite. There's a little bit of sharpness. But my tongue tingles because there's a little bit of sulfur. Nice, fruity, cherry moment. Cherry, brown sugar, caramel, corn syrup, sweetness. It's got a nice little moment going on in there. It's got good flavor. Glenrothes often has, for me, orange peel, candied orange peel, caramel orange peel. I'm getting that a little bit. A very, very nicely done whiskey. The sulfur is at the just barely perceivable, and it's not yet disturbing. If I put water in there that I did in my German video, it does get more. It really, that sulfur is activated, and so water was not the thing you need here. But even despite its 12 years, this whiskey has a little bit of a sharpness of a bite of the alcohol. All right. So the Buna 12, nothing. Smooth, silky, well balanced. This has a little bit of a thing off. It's interesting. Usually in my videos, I do my German video and then I do my English video, and often I'll go up just a half of a point. I'm going to go down half of a point. The more I try this, the less I like it. So I gave this a C++ in my, no, I gave it a C to C+ in my German video. I'm going to stick with a C. On a good day, it could be a C+, but there's two things that really knocked down some points: that sulfur and the alcohol bite of this whiskey. $64.90, $59.90, however you look at it at the moment, is a price I would be willing to pay for this whiskey. I don't know if I'd go out and buy another bottle of that, but it does have that nice, it has a good aftertaste. The finish is there, but then it fades away. But I do not like sulfur in my whiskey, and it has a tiny little bit. Points deducted. All right, going over to Buna 12 as a comparison. If I had to choose which one, it's going to be the Buna 12. There's a darkness, as in a leatheriness, and there is a little bit more of a. This is a brighter cherry moment. This is a darker plum moment. Baked apple, a little bit of a greener apple. Both are good. This is better. €15 cheaper, and both 12 years of age, both single malt, both sherry and bourbon cask matured. My question of the day is, you have £60, you have $60, you have 60 euros. Sorry, America, you're a little bit shorted there with your $60, and you have to buy a age-stated sherry bomb. What would you buy? I'd buy probably Buna 12. What would you buy? All right. Thank you very much for watching, liking, subscribing. This gets a C, value for money, C minus. On a good day, it would be a C plus, value for money, C. Without the points deducted for a little bit, that faint sulfur moment there. Thank you very much. Like, subscribe, tell others. See you very soon. Whiskey Jason here. Bye-bye.